Now, another really big important step, and this is going to be a first in the nation step. You're going to hear from our health commissioner in a moment, and he will be issuing a commissioner's order for all private sector employers in New York City. It is time. Look, this is how we put health and safety first, by ensuring that there is a vaccine mandate that reaches everyone universally in the private sector. A lot of folks in the private sector have said to me they believe in vaccination, but they're not quite sure how they can do it themselves. Well, we're going to do it. We're going to do this so that every employer is on a level playing field. One universal standard starting December 27th. We're going to be working with businesses all over the city, and that's almost 200,000 businesses that are not already covered by the Key to NYC guidelines right now. We're going to be working with the business community. We're going to be talking to them in the next days on how to put together the right plan to implement this. The specific guidance, the specific rules will come out on December 15th. We want to have a collaborative process. We want to make this work. And let's be clear, we have a great example with the Key to NYC. All those restaurants, all those fitness clubs, all those entertainment facilities, movie theaters, all sorts of places, they've been working with us. They gave us good advice up front. We came up with rules that worked. The vast, vast majority have implemented those rules really effectively. And I constantly hear from people that they know if they go into a place under Key to NYC, they're safe. And they feel comfortable. They're going to enjoy themselves. They feel comfortable in those settings because they know everyone's vaccinated. And there was a lot of concern up front. Would it work? Would it be difficult? You know what? Businesses have adapted and handled it really, really well. And we know that will happen again.
The New York City mayor just today says he's requiring everybody. He means they had a public sector vaccine mandate in place. But he says now private employers by the middle of December need to start getting everybody vaccinated. Listen to the mayor.
Our health commissioners put a series of mandates in place. They have won in court, state court, federal court, every single time, Jonathan. And it's because they're universal and consistent, and they're about protecting the public right now from a clear and present danger.
A, do you agree with that policy? And B, is that more to deal with this Delta surge, Delta spike, whatever you want to call it, or is that more, in your view, a protective measure that Omicron is coming, it's going to be here in bigger numbers soon, let's be ready?
Well, first of all, I do agree with the mayor's conclusions about the importance of this. New York City is ripe for a major surge in cases. If you look at the percentage of individuals vaccinated there, it is far, far below what we see in a number of the Western European countries right now that are having major outbreaks with the Delta variant and highest numbers of hospitalizations they've had in the pandemic. So yes, you want to be vaccinated. But the good news here is if you want to take care of Delta, it'll also take care of Omicron. Basically, we know right now that this virus variant may actually evade some of the immune protection from either vaccination or previous infection. But even the early data out of South Africa tells us that if you are vaccinated, you have a much less likelihood of having serious illness, hospitalizations, or deaths. So I think, again, this is one where it's take care of one, you take care of the other.
And I do want to note, you keep mentioning vaccinations, and I completely understand why. There are, the trend lines there are better. They're not fantastic, but they are certainly better. The seven-day average of new vaccine doses administered up 76% from just a month ago. It does seem like, number one, the availability of boosters. Number two, though, talk of Omicron has people getting more vaccines. And the percentage of people new, fully vaccinated Americans, the seven-day average there, people reaching full vaccination, is up 96% from just a month ago. So you do see some encouraging signs there. One of the questions is, when you listen to the experts in South Africa, they keep saying that everything they see, despite an explosion of cases because of Omicron, they're saying moderate to mild illness, and they believe that will hold up. When will we know, as that new variant travels the world, whether that will hold up?
Well, at this point, the number of cases in South Africa, which is climbing very quickly, has been really predominantly in younger kids, which we know are not as likely to have severe illness. So, I think it's going to take us another 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks in South Africa to understand, is this going to spill over into older populations, people who are immune compromised, et cetera. The same thing is true around the world. My first impression as somebody who's been in the trenches for 45 years fighting these viruses is this one is different, this new variant, Omicron. It's one that's much more highly transmissible than Delta. There's no question about that. The question, though, is will it cause milder illness? And I think so far the data support that. I reserve the judgment in the next 2 weeks to say, well, once it got seeded into all the other populations of high-risk individuals for serious illness, it changed. But right now I don't see any evidence of that.
Given what we've been through the last year and a half plus, I completely understand your caution and really and need to study a bit further. Dr. Osterholm, as always, so grateful for your insights.
Thank you.
Very important. Thank you.
Thank you.